Okay, so we're looking at evapotranspiration over here, and we're looking specifically, I'm just going to borrow this from the generalized watershed loading function. So generalized watershed loading function is an extremely parsimonious model. Anyone tell me what parsimonious means? It means simple and inexpensive. So it doesn't take a lot of time and effort. So it's a simple model, and it recognizes it as itself. But the rainfall and runoff use the SCS curve number, and then the evapotranspiration is taken from I'll tell you that in a minute. A guy called Heyman. So Heyman wrote a paper, I think, in 1961. And really, evapotranspiration is this whole idea, when is evapotranspiration going to be highest? Duh, right? When's that going to be? In the summer, when it's hot, and you've got lots and lots of green things evaporating and off, okay? So, and then in the winter, as plants shut down, evapotranspiration almost goes down to a minimum. So evapotranspiration really is a function of daylight hours. Temperature and cover, okay? Because if you have 50 acres and 25% of those acres are covered by cement, you know, it doesn't matter how many daylight hours that you have. The other thing in terms of evapotranspiration is in the summer, sometimes when you get below wilt point and your plants begin to wilt, your evapotranspiration is not as high. So there are ways of dealing with that, but we're going to look at this whole of idea of a potential evapotranspiration. So evapotranspiration is essentially the multiplication of a cover factor, which is almost linear from 0 to 1, times your potential ET, or evapotranspiration. So again, the assumption, what's the assumption? It's over a large homogeneous vegetation covered area that never lacks water. So as soon as you lack water, plants go like this and your ET goes down because there's no more water to transpirate over there, or transpire. So the formula over here is in the book, and we plug it into the equation, and I'll show you that. It's this formula. That's your daylight hours times, I think, what is it? That's your saturated water vapor pressure over temperature plus, what is this thing over here? Kelvin, okay. So it's just a temperature adjustment. And your vapor pressure is this one over here. And you can see all your vapor pressure is essentially a function of temperature. So this is a physical equation where, for all intents and purposes, it's fairly precise and fairly accurate as well. Because it's like water, dissolved oxygen in water, you can really track that quite easily with very high precision and very high accuracy. So the same thing over here. What does that look like? Well, in the generalized watershed loading function, they actually have a daylight hours a table. So you can look that up, and I think I put it in the spreadsheet. We'll look at that in a minute. But you can see your hours increase, and increase obviously over the summer. Why would daylight hours be important?
This is the hours you're going to get the most evapotranspiration.
Okay, why?
Because the sun's out.
The sun's out, and what are plants doing?
They're photosynthesizing.
They're photosynthesizing. Right, so you've got this metabolism going on, and that's when that's going to happen. Of course, when the sun's out, that's when the plant has to cool itself. So it cools itself through that transpiration process. So we're also getting evaporation off water bodies, but the transpiration component of the evapotranspiration is certainly the largest one, because it's a biological thing, and these plants are actively working to stay cool. So the, your cover factor in general, your cover coefficients are between 0 and 1. And they've got a few cover coefficients there. And they will basically approach 1 when your plants have, or approach their maximum when plants have full foliage. But if you have a cover that where you have a full canopy, then that would be 1 over there. Well, here is evapotranspiration measures both transpiration and evaporation of soil water. I don't know what that means, the lower liver. The lower limit essentially represents a situation without any plant cover. Okay, so when you have the lower limit of this thing, and when you evaporate, your cover is close to 0, that is essentially like a parking lot or barren soil, then essentially the only thing that's going to come out is your evaporation from the soil. Obviously, if you protect the soil with impervious areas, you're not going to have any evapotranspiration. So that's essentially the role of the cover factor. This is a fairly crude one, but again, if you're trying to kind of get a handle on what your evapotranspiration is, I was in a court, or not a court case, but I was an expert witness. You know what an expert is? Someone from more than 50 miles away with a briefcase. Or an ex is a has-been and a spurt is a drip under pressure. I sometimes refer to myself as the latter. Okay, so here are some of the cover factors that you can see. You can see for annual crops, you know, in the dormant season, it's down to 0.3. So there might be some weeds or something like that growing in an annual, like in a cornfield. You know, you might have some chickweed and hemp growing. So they assign a 0.3 cover factor, whereas in the growing season, they'll assign a growing factor, especially once that plant canopies. So you've got different things, but you can see it's pretty much 0.3 to 0.1. And then in urban areas, okay, Maria will get this on camera, you're taking 1 minus the impervious fraction. So that will, I think that's part of your exercise today. So these are very simple lookups, and again, this is not to kind of get something super, super, super accurate, but it gives you an idea of, you know, what's going to go, what's going on there. So if you have cropland, excuse me for a minute, it's my son texting me. So, in cropland, if you have right now, cropland will be dormant. If you have an average temperature of 69 degrees F, it's 20.5 degrees. It's basically a worked example. So you look up at this time of the year, the hours of daylight are going to be 22 hours. You calculate your water vapor pressure would be 24 millibar. You plug and choke to get the potential evapotranspiration. And I didn't work through that one, so I don't know. The potential evapotranspiration comes out in centimeters. Okay, centimeters of water that's evaporated.
So is that how much you're getting for one day?
Correct. It's a, okay. Thank you. Yeah. So the basis is one day. So one day. So typically, and let's go have a look at an example in the spreadsheet over here. Number 8, is that one? No, that's not what I wanted. Save. Bear with me here, guys. I think I brought the wrong one.
Yeah, that's mine I brought in the other day.
Yeah. Don't show that one. Okay. I'm going to ask. The setup is fairly easy. It's essentially we've got average evapotranspiration over 12 months. I apologize, that's my fault. But essentially, we have ET over 12 months, January to December. You plug in your hours per day. You plug in your average temperature, which I think I give you or give you a reference to. I'll make sure you've got that. And then you will. There's a question on your cover. I think I have cover for impervious area versus, you know, cover somewhere else. And essentially, what happens is your average daily evapotranspiration. I think we compare evapotranspiration versus potential PET. Okay. Is you essentially from January to December, you kind of get this curve over here. It's quite distinct and marked. So this, let's say this is potential evapotranspiration. So if your cover factor is less than one, you know, you're gonna kind of get this sort of thing. Okay, because your actual evapotranspiration, again, average daily actual evapotranspiration, if your cover is less than 100%, it's going to be less than your potential evapotranspiration. And now this doesn't account for soil moisture, where if your soil gets so dry beyond below wilting point, you would have a problem. So you'll see this again. I don't think this exercise is going to take you more than about 45 minutes to do. It's out there. If anyone has questions or problems, I'm not going to be here on Wednesday. But if you have questions or problems, let me know and we can look at that. But it's really a fairly simple exercise. So it's kind of, you just plug it and chug it into the formula, and that's what it is. All right, Gabe, thanks.